This is one similarity we can see in the all kinds of organisms. Then next, and one more thing we have to consider that if it comes to the cell level, there is a small differentiation among the cells. In all the types of living organisms, if you see, they are made up of two types of cells. What are they? Prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. So what are prokaryotic cells? The cells which does not have distinct, nucleus. What are prokaryotic cells? Prokaryotic cells are those. They have nucleus. They have genetic material, but that is not a distinct nucleus. Whereas in the eukaryotic cells, if you see, they are having with distinct nucleus. So this is a differentiation among the living organism cells. So much of diversity in the living organism, but still the living organism will start its life in a single cell. So that's why we are learning it as a structural and functional unit of an organism. And among the cells, living cells, if you see, two types are there: prokaryotic cells and the eukaryotic cells. What are prokaryotic cells? Cells does not have distinct nucleus. They do have nucleus, but that is not distinct. And whereas the eukaryotic cells are those with distinct nucleus. So this is about the cellular organization in organisms, in all types of living organisms. Now the second similarity we have to study is cellular structural complexity. So next similarity is structural complexity. So what is meant by complexity? Complexity is nothing but something is becoming complex. In previous similarity, we have studied that cell is a basic unit and every organism has to start its life with the cell. But if you single cellular organism. these are the two types of chemical reactions which takes place inside the organism. What is anabolism? Anabolism is nothing but it is a formation of a compound. So it's a reaction where some compounds are formed. Then it is called as anabolism, formation of an product or a compound. Catabolism means what? Breakdown of that same compound is called as catabolism. So anabolism is a reaction where the compounds are formed. During that time, energy is utilized. Okay? Then catabolism is what? The compound is broken down. When the compound is broken down, energy will be released. So energy will be utilized by the organism and it will be releasing the energy also. So that is a similarity we can see in the all type of organisms. So what are the similarities we have studied so far? Previously we have studied cellular organization, then we have studied structural complexity, then sensitivity, growth, how it is, internally growth is there, and in terms of mass and size the growth will be there, and energy utilization, every organism will perform or will be using energy, and they will be performing metabolisms. Metabolisms are nothing but some of chemical reactions. How about the chemical reaction? What are the types of chemical reactions taking place? Anabolism, catabolism. Anabolism is nothing but formation of compounds, and catabolism is nothing but breakdown of compounds. Okay, now we will study some more similarities in the organism. Okay, so we will start with the next similarity, and that is homeostasis. So what is homeostasis? Homeostasis is nothing but homeo means constant. Okay, or it should be same. So constant type of internal environment will be maintained by every organism. So every organism maintains constant internal environment. This is about the environment inside, not outside. So outside environment is not in the hands of the living organism. Okay, so the nomenclature. Then trinomial nomenclature. Then third one is tautomony. So binomial nomenclature, if you see here, the species is, the organism is named with two words. Okay, the organism is named with the two words. What are the two words? One is genus and the other one is species. Okay, then Okay, so Ssvb is a name, a scientific name of honeybee. and what